SG College of Plants and Science, Coimbatore. And my topic is on herbal salts and effective medication against plantar hyperkeratosis. Plantar hyperkeratosis is nothing but a cracked heel, which commonly occurs in adults. And the causes for this condition is due to genetic factors, that is the skin structure or the allergic dermatosis or certain kind of cancers, that is paraneoplastic syndrome, in particular internal malignancies. The treatment for this kind for this disease has been suggested by using so many herbs. So my work is to do, I have concentrated on this medication by using the salts, that is one daily. Because people don't take care for their feet, almost they don't go, they don't care for their feet, they don't allow time. So many people are working today. So for that purpose,
I stop talking, please.
So for that purpose, I have done this using the socks, that is one daily. So I've chosen two herbs, Solanum xanthocarbon and aloe vera, for this study. So this is a pictorial representation for the stage of plantar hyperkeratosis. The grade 0 shows, the figure 1 shows the grade 0 which doesn't have any scaling, but it may be dry, but there is no scaling. The other grades, we have the second grade 1 showing slight scaling and skin thickening. The third grade shows a deep fissure, and the fourth has a good thickening, and the next one shows fissure bleeding. The final stage is the most worsened case in the stage of plantar hyperkeratosis. So coming to the methodology, I have chosen two herbs, namely Solanum xanthocarbon and aloe vera. So I have gone for nanoparticle synthesis. Why have I gone for nanoparticle is that the plant extracts as a crude cannot be coated onto socks. If at all it is coated, when we are washing the socks, it moves away easily. So I bought for nanoparticle synthesis. So I've synthesized using iodine gelification method by Zahur Ahmed et al., which contains chitosan and sodium alginate as a polymer. Inside that polymer, my nanoparticle, that is comitonorial extracts of the herbs are present. So I've characterized it using characterized physically and chemically. Physically using DLS and chemically using FTIR analysis. And after that, I have coated the nanoparticle onto the socks by using fabric method. After that, I have assess the antibacterial activity and as well as the anti-hyperkeratosis activity. Antibacterial activity according to the American standards and anti-hyperkeratosis activity in vivo study I have done. Finally, I have assessed the dawn durability also to check till which wash my socks is effective. So the results, first I have gone for the phytochemical analysis of the methanolic extract. Actually the antibacterial activity was high in methanolic extract, so I have chosen the methanolic extract. So the amino acids and flavonoids were absent in aloe vera, and all the other compounds were present in both the plants. So next, I characterized physically, and my nanoparticles were around 88 nanometer when I did it in dynamic light scattering. And my nanoparticles were stable since the zeta potential was -25.4, and the H-atom analysis shows that the nanoparticles were smooth, spherical, and it was around 50 nanometer. So after that, I have analyzed these socks chemically. So the spectrum shows the both treated and untreated socks. We can see so many peaks in the treated socks, and that regions I have mentioned here, that is the 2916 region and 3139 region. All these regions, amino acid groups and the CO stretch alcohol that are present in my compound, that is in the combinatorial herbs, has been attached to the socks. I confirmed that by using FTIR analysis that my socks has the nanoparticles. And after that, the antibacterial activity was assessed. The sample was taken from the person who has hyperkeratosis activity and was directly plated. And from that, I have analyzed the zone of inhibition of my nanoparticle. And the zone was around 17 millimeter. And this plate shows the AADCC-147, which is in standard test for fabrics. So I've done it. That also shows my socks is antibacterial in nature. So after that in vivo analysis, we can see before treatment the person has the person's grade may be like she's from the second grade, and after using the socks for 20 days, it has not completely cured, but the stage of the hyperkeratosis has reduced from the earlier stage. So if the socks is being used for a longer time, it may be a promising cure for curing plantar hyperkeratosis. And this is the graphical representation that I have collected from so many persons. And also I found that that all the persons of all age weren't cured. That is, when the people were aged, like when the people of around 60 to 65 years, they didn't show any much improvement. Just the scaling or only the, there was a very slight change, so that I couldn't confirm that the socks alone is not the cure for plantar hyperkeratosis. The age and the other environmental factors are also responsible for the cure. That is, their diet and as well as their occupation, everything counts for the cure. But people who are at the age of 20 to 28 had showed a good reduction. That is, the last patient was suffering from fourth grade, who was 28 years old, but she, after the use of 20 days, she showed a good result. That is, after that her grade was reduced to first grade. That is, the dryness and all the other hardening, skin thickening has reduced, and only the dryness of the skin remained. So only two patients out of my study showed a very good result, and others showed a slight change. That is, from grade 2 to grade 1, or from grade 2 to grade 3, but they didn't show a very good effect. And I think this is because of the limited, that is, my nanoparticle has the herb itself. So so after that, if I get the bioactive compound, so which compound is very effective? So the amount of compound is more inside my nanoparticle, that will be an effective cure. So after that, laundering accessibility, I did the laundering durability. It was effective only till 20 washes. So I conclude that my socks is both antibacterial and proves a promising cure for hyperkeratosis also. And this activity is due to the sustained release of the herbs from the nanoparticles. It doesn't, all the herbs doesn't get released at a time, but since it is inside a nanoparticle, it releases slowly, and the cure is also good. So this people who are suffering from diabetes and other disease are already immunocompromised. These kind of conditions would burden them more. So these kind of socks would be a better option for them for curing the foot ulcers or foot care and diabetic patients. Thank you.
I have two technical questions.
Yes.
And they're to do with the details that I'm curious about. You measured the zeta potentials, the nanoparticles. Could you explain what the zeta potential is and why it's important?
Because since it is nanoparticles, my nanoparticles should not aggregate each other. So the nanoparticles aggregate, then there is no, it is not at all a nanoparticle. So by analyzing the zeta potential of the nanoparticle, the stability of the nanoparticle will determine. So since it is between minus 30 to plus 30, mine was minus 25.4. So I say that my particles were highly stable and they did not aggregate on any conditions.
Can you define the zeta potential?
That's fine.
There was something curious about your laundering activity.
Yes, sir.
Laundering results. As a mathematician, I would expect to see an exponential decrease with the number of launderings. But you got something approximating to a linear decrease, which is curious, because it indicates that there's a layering effect of some kind. Could you comment? 5 washes reduced by 70%, by 30%. The next 5 washes reduced by not 30% of the remainder, but by a full 30%. Okay? Whereas if it had just reduced it by 30%, it would have only gone down to 50% instead of 41%. So you're getting a kind of linear reduction. It's just curious, that's all.
Yes, sir. Even I'm not sure about it, but maybe it is due to the detergent amount we used. We used generally a mild detergent, but I'm not sure about what happens during the what is the exact mechanism of the laundering durability. just we have analyzed the long-range durability till which the antibacterial activity is there, we have analyzed, but I haven't gone such deep.
Now, is your understanding, you've used two herbs.
Yes, sir.
Is your understanding that the aloe vera has an antibacterial effect or merely an assuaging effect on the soreness of the heels?
Why did I choose aloe vera? It naturally has a moisturizing effect. When we wear socks, normally our feet gets moisturized, and this also adds to the moisturizing effect. When in the moisturized condition, there is a chance for the bacterial growth. So I have used aloe vera. Solanum xanthocarpum, which will reduce, that is, which will not allow the bacterial activity there.
Solanum is an antibacterial.
Yes.
And the other is potentially a moisturizer.
Yes.
Good.
In your in vivo study, you said that it has actually improved for all patients who wore these socks. So how do you know it's not just because of wearing socks? Because a lot of plantar hyperkeratosis just happens because people move about with open feet and there's dirt that goes in. So could you attribute this result just to the wearing of socks, or is it indeed due to the herbs that you've used?
Yeah, it is because of both, because of wearing socks as well as of the herb. I have analyzed just applying the herb also. We have done the formulation, and I've seen the activity in many patients just the formulation itself. By using paraffin wax, I've formulated it. And in patients, when I have given the ointment to the patients, I've asked them to apply every night. But still, I didn't know whether they applied it or not. But when I gave the socks to those patients, I said them to wear it. So I did not see a much difference in people who just applied ointment and who are wearing socks. But wearing socks is like people who go for work, who have other things to do. They don't care about their feet. Actually, most of the people, not only people who are very beauty conscious. And people who are very beauty conscious care about their feet, but still people who are immunocompromised, who work every day. I've done my work in people in my college, securities who are there in my college, housekeeping people of my college only I've studied.
Yes.
So those people are not ready to apply ointments and all. So my idea was to give socks so that they can wear it and go all around. So that was me.
What I mentioned is wearing socks only. What I meant is sometimes just wearing socks and keeping your feet covered. So it would have been a good idea to have a few control people. I mean, even among 82 people, just wore socks and did not have any nanoparticles or any
I paid people to just wear socks. Even in that people, I had seen the reduction in. This is because why did I go for coating? This is aloe vera gives extra moisturizing effect, as well as in people with diabetic patients who are fishers.
What she means to say that you have to confirm the results in a controlled study. That some people will wear the only socks, and some people will wear the socks which you have specially prepared. And then you have to compare, and then you can ascertain that the results are only because of the urban medicated socks.
Okay, ma'am, sure. Thank you.
One more thing, you have do you have any idea that what is the effect of the socks on the normal flora?
Sorry, sir.
What is the effect of the socks on normal flora?
I have collected a sample from both the people who are having hyperkeratosis activity, and normally people who wear socks due to the when we wear socks, there is a moisturizing effect in that wet region. The bacteria called Bribibacteria, which gives this foul smell. So that kind of bacteria is the most prevalent one. In the normal flora...
That is not normal flora.
Yeah, that is not normal flora, but in normal flora, I isolated SRS was present in the normal flora, and many other bacteria were present, but still, I did not study about the normal flora condition, but I studied only from patients who had hyperkeratosis, so I did not go for the normal flora.
So you recommended only for patients?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.